Can I please start by asking each of you, well, I suppose at the beginning, Louise, how you felt when you approached about an adaptation, if you felt like you didn't want it to go out into the world, or you were really pleased? How did you initially feel? Do you remember?
I was thrilled to bits, but also quite trepidatious, because as is obvious from that, it's a book that's very dear to my heart. It's a very personal book. As a middle-aged woman, it's very much a book about a middle-aged woman. It was easy to see how it could have been got really wrong, I think, in the wrong hands. So it was really fantastic when I met all these guys. The seriousness with which they took it and their commitment to the project was really amazing. And I sort of knew straight away I was in safe hands, and after that I was okay. But in the run-up to it, I was quite trepidatious. It's very anxiety-provoking publishing a novel, because you never know how it's going to be received, and then it's kind of fresh load of anxiety when it's going out in a different medium. So I was just really, really grateful to realise that it was in very safe hands.
And how much did you and Amanda talk to each other about the whole process of writing it? And I presume it wouldn't be right for you to be looking at
authors. Absolutely not. No, I was really happy to go, here it is, Amanda. It's your problem now. I was completely clear. I had no desire to be involved in writing the adaptation. I actually think there should be a law against novelists adapting their own books for the screen.
Because they're too precious.
They're too precious. You're too involved. You tend to want to keep scenes that have been difficult to write, which are not necessarily the best scenes or the scenes that will
just
work well.
Just the agony of
so much into them. So I was completely clear right from the start that I wasn't interested in doing that. And luckily, I really, really loved Amanda's work, and I'd seen her adaptation of Room at the Top, which I just thought was just wonderful. And as soon as they mentioned her name, I was like, phew, I can just step back safely now.
Okay, and Amanda, what was your starting point?
In terms of coming onto the project?
Yes. Did you read the book when it first came out?
Kudos, Amanda Levin, kudos. Sent it to me. I think the book had just come out, and so I came to it like any other reader. You know, it's a great book, and it's such a page turner, and I was gripped, and I read it incredibly quickly. But also, I was, you know, with my other hat on, thinking, yeah, I can see how this would really, really work on screen. So it was exciting.
And was it apparent early on that it should be a four-parter as opposed to a 90-minute standalone drama?
I think so. I mean, we obviously talked quite a bit about length, and yeah, you get a feeling when you're reading books with a view to adaptation about, you know, like, is it going to be a skirt or a dress or, you know, three-piece suit? I mean, it felt like there was a lot in there, and to do it justice, doing it as a single would have maybe sensationalised aspects that, you know, wouldn't have done justice to all the things in the book and the subtleties, which were what attracted me to it, this idea that you can have something that's got legs as a story, you know, and the pulse of a thriller, but is about so much else. Yeah.
Okay, and Jess, when you came on board, what were your main concerns, I suppose, about bringing it onto the small screen?
Just how people might respond to seeing it. But I knew what was important was to kind of walk in her shoes. And if we can get the bomb's point of view right, we should be okay. And it was just making it that very particular personal, so that we weren't ahead of what was happening in the story. And Louise did that really beautifully in the book, and then Amanda continued that through the script. So I felt we, as long as we were true to that, we would be okay. That was my biggest thing. I thought if we started to get ahead of her, then we'd lose it. So.
Okay, and for you, what did you feel when you first read the script? Did you think, shit, I can't do this, or it's too exposing, or did you immediately see it as just a brilliant role to challenge you?
When I first read it, I thought, really? I mean, it was made me very nervous. But then I went to meet Jess, and that she completely turned me around, really. I feel it's has come something like this come to a time in my career when the roles for women in women of my age in movies get smaller and smaller and smaller, and I think in television, this is about a fully a grown-up woman who is powerfully sexual and has a complex life. And those women aren't really represented on screen very much. That point in a woman's life where she is, a properly sexual grown-up is, we don't see it traditionally.